Within this video, I'm going to give you 5 things for you to be doing on a weekly basis so that you can hike better on the weekends. Now, if you're into endurance training or you like hiking, ultra running, trail running, cycling, all the things for a long period of time, i.e. endurance training, you're going to want to hit subscribe and make sure you hit that bell icon so you don't miss my next video. Otherwise, let's dive into this video and I'm gonna show you 5 things that you can do throughout the week to make sure that your hiking on the weekend is more enjoyable, you feel less fatigue, and you feel like you're actually gonna be able to enjoy all these amazing places that this place has to offer. Come here. All right, let's jump in. Tips that I would recommend so that you can enjoy your hiking on the weekend in a more enjoyable fashion because you physically are ready to go. I'm going to jump in right now, and my point number one is going to be 15 and 15. Now, what I mean by that is throughout the week, you're going to want to apply 15 minutes throughout possibly each day on stressing the musculoskeletal system about 15 minutes per day. Now, that could range from doing things like bodyweight squats, step ups, lunges, to even a bridge or a plank. Now, what that's going to do is allow you to stress your muscles in that very loaded pattern. Now, obviously the activity that we're looking for is to head out for hiking. So making sure that you have really strong legs is gonna be a great advantage for you out there for when you're out there 3 hours, 4 hours, depending on what sort of hiking ability that you're up to. But having strong legs is going to go a long way. So my recommend to you is 15 minutes of micro stressing the muscles. So again, lunges, squats, hinges, to get the legs really to engage, and just spend 15 minutes on that per day. Now the other 15 minutes is to mobilize and stretch those same muscle groups. So if you think about it, on a Monday to Friday, 15-15 type mindset, where you're doing 15 minutes to stress the muscles, and then you're applying 15 minutes to lengthen the muscles. And what you will find is as the weeks progress, especially about the 6 week to the 8 week mark, you will find that as your hiking hours start to elevate as the weekends progress, you'll probably find that you'll be able to do more and more and more just because your legs aren't going to give away. Okay, so my next thing's going to be all about your daily steps and your daily stairs that you can get in, and hopefully it's not going to be too much of an impact throughout your day. Sometimes we try to overshoot the simple things, right? So if you're really looking to improve your fitness, sometimes you can do a really good training session in the morning, and that actually makes you more basically redundant throughout the day because that training session is actually too exhausting for the body. If you're looking at doing more hiking and you'd like to feel better equipped to do this hiking, then increasing your daily steps on average is going to want to be one of your most important focuses that you can work on. Take the stairs every chance that you get. If you're in Sydney, Australia, and you're spending time up at the Blue Mountains, well, any stairs you can get underneath your legs is always going to be a really, really good thing. So you don't want to take away from the easy stuff, or you don't want to take away from the things that you don't usually think about, is that set a daily step goal and see how many stairs that you can take throughout the day. So if you are at work, don't take the elevator, go up and down the stairs. So let's say you're looking after point number one and point number two, where you're getting your steps in and you're applying these 15-15, both mobility stretches and micro tears into your weekly flow. The third one is I'm gonna recommend is jump on a bike. A bike, a spin bike, great way for you to increase your aerobic fitness without necessarily putting a whole bunch of activity on top of your feet. Now, obviously hiking and things like running, you apply a lot of stress onto things like knees and ankles and just your joints. Whereas if you had a bike or an option to jump on a bike, whether that's at a gym, that is a great way for you to continue to condition your aerobic conditioning for those hikes on the weekends. And you'll probably find that it might actually enhance your recovery just because that a bit of extra easy movement. You can lay off the legs a little bit so that you can save majority of that impact work when you're out there hiking on the weekend. Now, I'm sure that you're doing hiking for a pleasure activity, but I can tell you right now, getting up early on whatever morning that you're gonna head out and not necessarily feeling your utmost best, sometimes it can come to, what did you do the night before? And I'm more talking about the alcohol that you could possibly be consuming. And that is absolutely one of my biggest tips, is that at least the night before, lay off the alcohol. It is going to dehydrate you. You're going to wake up in the morning feeling groggy, feeling more tired. And if you've done all these amazing things throughout the week, well then realistically, you're not going to do yourself any favors anyway. So I would start the night before with making sure that you're hydrated, making sure that you've got a nice light meal the night before so that you're not sort of waking up and feeling groggy from both either alcohol or just the food in general. And get those electrolytes in. That could be the morning of, or at least the night before you go to bed. So that way when you wake up in the morning, you're actually fresh, ready to go. You've had a nice good sleep, because if you're using alcohol as an aid to get to sleep, yes, it will knock you out, but no, you do not get the same quality sleep as if you were to not drink that alcohol. So really, really important for that tip is that at least the night before, lay off the alcohol if you want to feel good out there hiking and experiencing all those amazing highs and views. Okay, and that leaves me with my very last point, is that you're going to want to be consistently inconsistent. Talk about an oxymoron, right? Now, what I mean by that is if you look at it over a mesocycle, so let's say 6 to 8 weeks, you're gonna wanna be really consistent with these things that I'm actually mentioning. Again, talking about your daily steps, your daily stairs, making sure that you have a bit of time to build some aerobic fitness, laying off the alcohol to improve that diet of yours. But also is that you want to make sure that if you wake up one day and you plan to get up and train, you're gonna have to be a little bit more adaptive and maybe not train. If you're training on absolute soreness from these micro sessions that you are doing, you might have to just take a bit of a break. So again, if you look at it on the large scale, you're being super consistent, but if you look at it day by day, it probably looks a little bit inconsistent. So if you set your week up and you have a training plan and you look at your week and you're organizing when you're gonna do all these things, sometimes you're gonna wake up in the morning and you're just gonna have to take the day to rest, to recover, so that way you can actually get all these adaptations that you're after out of these tips that I'm asking you to do. Okay, so that is my 5 tips or my 5 things for you to be thinking about if you're hiking on the weekend and you're just trying to improve and tweak your routine, or at least your Monday to Friday routine a little bit more to make these hikes a bit more enjoyable. I can tell you right now, if you go out for a few hours out hiking, or you get roped into hiking with the group, and you're not quite ready to do these sorts of things, it can be seriously, seriously uncomfortable too. Make sure that you're towards the front of the pack. You're gonna wanna focus on these 5 things. Number one, we're gonna go through those micro sessions and stretches. Number 2 is all talking about that daily steps and your stairs. Take the stairs, not the elevator. Number 3, if you have a chance, jump on a bike. It lays you off your feet. You don't get so sore from the impact work all the time. Number 4, i.e. everyone knows I love to talk about nutrition and diet, but lay off the alcohol the night before so that you're well hydrated and ready to go the morning of. And then your very last one is consistency is key. But down in the weeks and the days, you're gonna have to be a little bit inconsistent sometimes, because you're gonna have to take a rest day and maybe you didn't plan on taking it. So when you wake up in the morning and you're feeling a little bit, you know, how you're doing, take a rest day. There's no harm in taking a day off, and you'll probably be better off the next day for it. All right, guys, if you liked this video, comment down below, tell me what you like, tell me what I'm missing, and tell me some of the things that you do to make sure that you're ready to go for your next hike. Don't forget to subscribe and like this video. Otherwise, guys, I'll see you next time here on the Morris Method Coaching. Bye.